If you have ever visited a wildlife park, you must have been warned not to touch the animals or approach them. However, some people are fond of breaking the rules, then they get angry when they pay the price for their mistake. When all is said and done, those rules are just made to protect you, especially if you're in a wildlife park that has anacondas or crocodiles. Today's story is about three idiots in a boat mess with enormous anaconda. Huge mistake. But before we start, be sure to subscribe to Did You Know? And hit the bell so you never miss an upload from us. Also, leave a like right now. Messing with snakes is not something you can brag about because snakes are dangerous and you could get poisoned by their venom. This is not meant to be fun at all. It is life-threatening and a very stupid action. When those three people decided to trick an anaconda, they realized later on that they made a very big mistake that was needless from the first place. Well, sometimes you have to pay a very heavy price in order to learn a lesson. Because seriously guys, messing with an anaconda? If you know how huge, fast, and wild the anaconda is, you would certainly never challenge it. Those people thought themselves really brave, daring, challenging, and smart to torment an anaconda that was minding its own business. The three people we are talking about are from Brazil, a wife named Cirilli Oliveira, who is married to a man named Betino Borges, and their friend Rodrigo Santos was accompanying them. They were all on a boat in Santa Maria River, which is found in Mato Grosso do Sul. Supposedly, they were going fishing, but then they saw an anaconda. What would you normally do in a situation rather than freaking out? Use the oar to poke the wild beastie creature, of course? This was what Borges decided to do when he saw the anaconda. The anaconda had already eaten a large meal, and it was still apparent in its stomach that looked swollen. The woman screamed and wanted her husband to stop because she was scared, but he insisted on poking the anaconda with the wooden oar, and his friend pulled its tail. The anaconda could not resist and escape easily because of the swelling it had in its midsection after its large meal, so it was not easy for it to move freely. The two friends did not stop harassing the reptile and pulled its tail more than once while they were rowing their boat. Well, that was really evil. However, they did not run away with their terrible mistake. The wife, who took a video of her husband and their friend while tormenting the anaconda, posted the video on Facebook, completely oblivious to the fact that the video would put them in very big trouble. She, of course, posted the video by mistake. Then another video was uploaded on YouTube that showed the footage of the anaconda getting tortured and harassed by the two men. It was a yellow small anaconda, which is known in Brazil as sucuri. So, the videos uploaded on social media were enough evidence of harassing the serpent and exploiting the wildlife. The environmental police saw the video and, of course, they took quick measures to punish the three Brazilians who abused the anaconda. They were fined and each of them had to pay $600. And not only that, but it was said that they would be jailed for a year and a half because of their crime in violating the park's rules that prohibited hunting or chasing the wild animals. So, they brought themselves too many troubles because of their curiosity to see what the anaconda would do. The three Brazilians said that they did not intend to harm the reptile or to exploit anything. They just wanted to see how the reptile would behave when provoked. But the environmental police insisted that it was not an excuse to be ignorant of the law. In other words, they would receive their punishment even if they did not know the law. A police officer, who works for the environmental police, explained that animals' place was in nature and man's place was in a different corner and each one had a different role in life. He added that provoking an animal and capturing its footage just to make yourself famous was a very selfish attitude and indeed unforgivable. Well, Quiros is correct. Why would we abuse animals if they are just not harming us? There are no justifications or negotiations concerning this topic. Tell us what you think about that story in the comment section below. Do you think that it's an exaggeration to call it a crime, and why? Thanks for watching.